the New York Giants have remained coy on their plan at the quarterback position for the 2019 NFL offseason, but former NFL scout and current NFL Network draft analyst Daniel Jeremiah finds it very difficult to imagine them passing on the position in the first round of the 2019 NFL draft. In fact, Jeremiah referred to the possibility of the Giants passing on a quarterback with a top six draft pick for the second consecutive offseason as a tough situation for the franchise. For Giants, if they don't take a quarterback again all the way up here, you know, it would be interesting, Jeremiah said Monday during a conference call previewing the 2019 NFL Combine. We saw it, though, with Cleveland, trying to build up the team, and then eventually get that quarterback later on. The difference is that Cleveland didn't have a capable guy on campus already in Eli Manning, so yeah, I think it's a little different from that standpoint. It would be something they would have to answer a lot of questions about, I'll put it to you that way, if they were to escape the top 10 without a quarterback in back-to-back years. The question isn't do you take one, it's if you have one that you like, you might even have to just move up a little bit just to guarantee you get the guy that you like. That'll be a tough decision for them to make, but it would be very tough on that organization to have had two cracks at it and not come away with a quarterback. The Giants' offseason is here and the biggest decision is due on March 17th when Eli Manning's roster bonus has to be decided on. Stay up to date with everything Giants by taking a second to sign up for our free Giants newsletter. The first decision the Giants have to make involves a quarterback already on the roster. Veteran quarterback Eli Manning is set to enter the final year of his contract in 2019, but the Giants have not yet committed to bringing him back. Manning is due to receive a salary cap hit of $23.2 million in 2019, a hefty number for a quarterback who has thrown for just 40 touchdown passes over the past two seasons combined. Patrick Mahomes had 50 touchdowns in the 2018 season alone. The Giants would create $17 million in 2019 salary cap space if they released Manning. However, to create all $17 million in cap space, they would have to release him prior to the fourth day of the new league year, March 17. If the Giants don't release Manning prior to March 17, they will lock in a $5 million roster bonus. Once the Giants pay out the bonus against the 2019 salary cap, it's highly unlikely they will release him. The expectation is that the Giants will retain Manning for the 2019 season. Manning has been training at the Giants facility throughout the offseason. However, the fact that the franchise has taken this long to confirm their commitment to Manning is interesting. Giants fans will hope to get more answers about Manning and the quarterback situation moving forward on Wednesday at the Combine when both general manager Dave Gettleman and Pat Shurmur are slated to speak with reporters.